Hello friends, I am going to explain this problem. To find the area A, you should find here. This is the given two space. Side of the square is A, other side is B. They are given X and Y here. This is the length X, this is the length Y they are given. So what I will do? My convenient, I will make it, this is X1 and this is Y1. Later I will replace X1 with X, Y1 with Y. Suppose if I extend this line, I can extend this line, my convenient. Here I am going to extend this line, so I will extend this line, and this one I will extend this line, here also you can extend this line, so let it be, this is x axis, and you can consider as y axis, our convenient I have taken x axis and y axis, I have taken this. Now if I take x and y axis, so you can think immediately, you can think about, because we know that this is A means this length also A. This is the origin I have taken, this is A, this length is A. So I am trying to find these three points here. So I am trying to find these three points. Since when I have taken this length is A, correct? This again, this length is B. Definitely what about this point, you know? This point is A comma B. Clearly we know that. That point is A comma B. With intersection of these two, right? This is A comma B. So I got this point is A comma B. Because x and y axis, the point is a comma b. At the same time, your idea is should find these two points. If you know three points, easily you can find area of this triangle. So here, this line intersects this square and this square. But we know this line I can consider as, in this line, it is parallel to x axis. So in this line, wherever you take the point, y coordinate is b. You should find x coordinate here. Here, we know this is vertical line. If you go anywhere in this vertical line, x coordinate is same. You should find y coordinate here. So I want to solve this line along with this line and this line. Here clearly we know that I should solve that. Here by the way, you can see here. This is the line ferrite. What is this line equation if I consider? So here I can take, this is the point here. So this point I can consider. This is A. So this is A. I can consider that point is A. Because that line is x is equal to A. And this is x is equal to A. Now, here what I am saying here, how to find this point is, I try to find equation of this line. Equation of this line. Suppose let it be, this is the point P. This is the point Q. This is the point Q. When I have taken P point on x axis, see this is the distance A plus x1. This point will be A plus x1 comma 0. Because on x axis, y shift is 0. Same time, you think about y axis, if we take this, because we know this distance, this is b, this is also b, right? You know this length is b, this length is b, b plus y1. Immediately you can think about what about the point Q. So you think about the point Q will be, because the point Q will be, here on y axis, x should be 0, this is this point 0 comma b plus y1. 0 comma b, you look at 0 comma b plus y1. 0 comma b plus y1. I know P and Q points. Here you can also see OP is called X intercept and OQ is called Y intercept. Then what about equation of O? See, this is Y intercept, this is X intercept, OP is X intercept and OQ is Y intercept. Then if you know the intercept, I get an equation of PQ. So I can directly get an equation of PQ. So you can write equation of PQ is, I can write equation of PQ is, I can write this equation of PQ is x pi A plus x1 plus y pi B plus y1 is equal to 1. This is equation of PQ, right? Here I have written equation of PQ. Equation of PQ, I got this one. But I am trying to find, this is the point, you can see here. So these are three points, right? I can write the point here. This is anything I can write. These are the three points I am going to find here. First of all, I am planning to find this point. Suppose you can consider this is the point I want to find here. In this point, x value is A. Correct? This is x value A here. A comma. I want to find the y value of this. Y value of that. So y coordinate, x coordinate is A. Suppose if I replace x coordinate is A here to find this point. So if I replace x coordinate A here, you will get A by A plus x1 plus, let it be, this is equation 1. You will get y by B plus y1 is equal to 1. My aim is to find y coordinate here. So you will get y by b plus y1 is equal to 1 minus a by a plus x1. You simplify this, a plus x1 minus a by a plus x1. So you get cancel this one. So I can write y is equal to, transfer that side, x1 into b plus y1 by a plus x1. I got y coordinate. When I got y coordinate, immediately I can write this point will be, so automatically we can think about this point will be x1 into b plus y1, b plus y1 by a plus x1. A plus, that point I got, that vertex I got. Now I have to find another vertex, this one. So to find that vertex, so you know this is the line. So this is the line here, you know this line, this is the line. If I extend this line also, what do you think? This is the line. On this line, this is the parallel to x-axis. Here this line will be y is equal to b, right? Wherever you go on this line, y value b only. So here y coordinate b. I want to find x coordinate here, right? Y coordinate is b. I am trying to find here x coordinate. Because y coordinate is b. So x coordinate. This is I completed this one I written. Now I am trying to find a point here. I'm trying to find x coordinate here, y coordinate is b. I can consider this is the y coordinate is b. Y is b coordinate here. I should find this coordinate here. So you can go think about this one. It's clear this one. Y coordinate is b here. So since y coordinate, because this line is, you know, because I can find here, this is the square underscore here. It's clear. This I want to find only the this is I can write b. So, because why I should find x coordinate here. So, I should find x coordinate here. What I will do now, x coordinate, I will substitute again in this equation. I will substitute in the place of y, b, I will substitute, I will try to find x coordinate. So, I will try to do that. See, what I can do now, again, I am going to find some equation 1. So, again, in equation 1 only, I will try to find in equation 1. I will replace in the place of y, b, I will substitute here x by a plus x1. Plus you will get b by b plus y1 is equal to 1. So I am trying to find this point. So this will become here x by a plus x1 equal to 1 minus b by b plus y1. So you will get that. You will get b by b plus y1. Now simplify this. B plus y1 minus b by b plus y1. So you will get this one. So x is equal to y1 into a plus x1 by b plus y1. So here you will get this point will be y1 into a plus x1 by b plus y1. You will get this is the point, right? You will get that, right? Understand y1 into a plus x1. Write here, like I will write here y1 into a plus x1 by b plus y1, comma b. Correct? You will get like this, right? So this is the point B. So this is the point here. This is the point I got. I got 3 points, right? Then I can find the area of this. So because I know 3 points, after finding these 3 points, so because I understood now, after finding these 3 points, I am going to find area of the required triangle A. So this is the required triangle. So area is equal to this A is required area. So I am going to find the area of that. Now you can see how to find the area of that now. So to find the area of this triangle, I can consider to find the area of the triangle, I can write the area of the required triangle. So I can write this is A, capital A. This is area equal to 1 by 2. The coordinates I can write A, B. I have taken A, B. And I can write any order like this area, right? I can substitute the values of this one, I can write A, B. I have taken this one. And then this one I can write this y1 into a plus x1 by b plus y1. What this is I have written, and b, another one, this is a, and I have written this one x1 into b plus y1, because this is x1, right? B plus y1 by a plus x1, and again into a, b, I have taken this one. So this is the determinant I have taken like this. Find the area using cross multiplication method. So I can take it now. Here when I am finding area here, I can do the cross multiplication method. Like this, I can do this. I can do the cross multiplication method. I can find area of this. I am going to simplify this. If I simplify, I will get the required area, triangle area I will get. I am going to simplify now. The entire equation I am going to simplify. Then, if I simplify this, see this is, I have taken this one. And even I can write, of writing the points, I can write the point clearly here. This is the AB, I can repeat. Correct. I'm repeating that I am going to find a complete area now. This one I can consider. This is the thing, right? If I simplify, it gives required area. So now you can see applies here 1 by 2. Not just this one, you will get AB, I can write. AB into you will get. This less AB I have taken like this. AB into this one I will write. So you will get AB into, I have taken the point starting with this one. You will get like this AB into minus of, you will get BY1 into A plus X1 by, because try to understand, this is X1 only, A plus X1 by B plus Y1, B plus Y1, I have taken like this, this into this, next I can multiply these two. If I multiply these two, you can observe here, this into this plus, if you multiply this, you will get Y1 into, you can observe here Y1, Y1, you can X1, X1 by 1, you will get X1, Y1 into A plus X1 into B plus Y1 by A plus X1 into B plus Y1, right? Just you are multiplying. Now again, this multiplication over minus AB, again plus AB, I can consider plus AB minus, this is minus AB, you can write here, when I multiply this one, minus AB, next to plus AB, you get minus of AX1 into B plus Y1 by A plus X1, you will get like this. Here I am trying to find area of the triangle. So I am simplifying here. Now, and I am simplifying here, you can see here, you can observe here, this way I can eliminate this one plus AB minus AB, you can eliminate this one, right, this one I can eliminate. Even you can see a plus x1, b, b plus y1, I will get x1 by 1. You will get x1 by 1. So here, I'm going to simplify the entire equation now. This is the thing, you can see if I take LCM of this, I will take LCM of these two. So if you see 1 by 2, if I take LCM of these two, it will become ab square plus aby1 minus aby1. You will get minus AB Y1, you will get minus, X1 Y1 B, minus X1 Y1 B. I have taken, I multiplied this. So otherwise I will do one thing, is before writing this, here I will write first, what are the remaining here, I can write 1 by 2, 1 by 2, this one, X1 Y1, I have this one, AB minus B Y1, A plus X1 by B plus Y1 plus X1 Y1 minus of AX1 into B plus Y1 by A plus X1. When I am simplifying like this now, you can see here, this I can multiply this. I can write 1 by 2. So if I multiply this, what will be this result? It will become, I can write AB square, correct? This will be AB square, you will get ABY1 minus ABY1 minus X1 by 1B by B plus Y1. This one if you multiply, you will get AX1Y1 plus X1 square Y1, minus ABX1 minus AX1 by 1. Minus AX1 by 1 by, you will get A plus X1. So you will get A plus X1. Just I multiply this one, right? Here you will get minus AX1 by 1. Minus AX1 by 1. Clear? But this is minus AX1 by 1 by this. So here I can simplify this AB by 1. I can get cancel this AB by 1. Even I can see here, I can cancel this AX1 by 1. AX1 by 1, I can eliminate this. I can strike out this, right? Still, if I simplify this, further simplification, if we do that, so further simplification, do that, this is equal to 1 by 2, you got it again, you take LCM, if you take entire LCM, you will get b plus y1 into a plus x1, it comes. If you take enter this one, if you multiply this, I can multiply a, b, you can write here, this, if I take this one, a square b square, you will get a square b square, a b square x1, a b square x1, I multiply this, you will get minus, if I multiply this minus, I can write a b x1 y1, a b x1 y1, a b x1 y1, this one again, next, this one, with minus a b square x1, minus a b square x1, if you multiply this one, because I have here b plus y1, right, this is b plus y1, minus, you will get a b square, you will get minus a b square x1 y1, correct, this is, we have, this is b plus y1, I am multiplying this, again the same time, with this one, I can also write minus, you will get a b x1 y1, minus a b x1 y1, minus a b, I have written minus a b, x1 y1, and this one multiplying with this x1 square, this one you can multiply, you will get x1 square y1, you can see x1 square y1 b, you will get plus x1 square y1 b, x1 square y1 b, and again you will get x1 square y1 square plus x1 square y1 square, it comes x1 square y1 square will come. Now if you take x1 square y1 square will come. Now I can simplify any terms here, you can check that ab square x1, ab square x1, can I simplify this one, these two get cancelled, ab square x1 I can cancel, again you can see that x1 y1 you will get this two here, minus ab x1 y1, minus ab x1 y1, minus ab x1 y1, record it this one, when I multiplied here you will get four terms, I written one more term I am missing here. You can check that x1 square, I have written x1 square, y1 into y1, x1 square, y1 square written, and x1 square, y1b, x1 square, y1b. So if you are multiplying this, you will get total four terms you should get. You can also give, when you multiply this one, ab square b square, plus you got ab square x1, next one you got minus x1 y1, AB minus x1 y1 AB, you will get minus x1 square y1 B, minus x1 square y1, here you will get minus x1 square y1 B. Oh, here one more term we are missing here, so I should add one more term here, minus x1, because minus x1 square y1 B, so y1 B, when I am multiplying this one, so this one and this one get cancelled, x1 square y1 B, x1 square y1 B will get. And one more term you will get. This simplify, but one more term get cancelled here. Finally, you can see what it comes here. In the simplification, if you see the remaining terms, AB whole square, AB whole square, I have this one minus 2AB into X1 by 1, X1 by, you get X1 by, right? You will get 2AB into X1 by 1 plus X, you will get X1 by 1 whole square. So, by you will get b plus y1 into a plus x1. It comes like this, right? B plus 1, a plus x1. Now, the final answer, we got it now. This one, a minus b whole square form, you will get 1 by 2 mod, I can write this, ab minus x1 by 1 whole square by b plus y1 into a plus x1. I got this is the answer, right? But in the beginning, I have taken x as x1, y as y1 have taken, I should replace now. So actually the required area A is equal to, if I replace x1, x1 with x and y1 with y, so the required area equal to, I can write the required area equal to, the required area A is equal to, you will get, you can write this one, AB minus mod AB minus x1 y1 whole square, or sorry, xy, you replace that AB minus xy whole square by, you will get this 2 into, you can write A plus x into B plus y. So this is the required area. So thank you.